Hi everyone, welcome to September Empties. I have quite a lot, especially makeup, woohoo! As always, I'll try to put the new items of each section first, and so when you hit repeats, you can see the skip ahead times below. So the first item is this Intensives Vivid Color Hairspray by Graham Webb. I'm a big believer that every item either adds moisture or dries out. Hairsprays dry out. This one dries out more than any I've ever had. This is a very expensive one, and I have more of them, but I will use it up. It does hold. It does make, if you get it, you can't spray it like under your roots the way I like to do and then oomph it up. It will leave sticky pieces. It welds your hair together, so you have to be careful with this. Use it fairly far away, and like I said, it is quite drying. Speaking of drying, Tresemme Mousse, I liked it, but I realized when I was in Maui and did not take it how much this dries out my hair, and I'm going to be using less products and hopefully more moisturizing ones. So the only product I think that I need to use that's drying in my hair is hairspray, and that's usually going to be my Tresemme. But this mousse I will not be repurchasing, even though it works very well. My Isoplus Hot 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 Curl, it's the only thing that keeps any curl in my hair. Around 100 today, and my hair will hold this curl all day long. So love it, because I have stick straight hair. My Revlon hair color, I did the video on how I color my hair, and I'm a mad chemist, and I got asked some good questions. I keep an empty one of these so that I can mix it and see how high up in the container I am. And so, I know when I have 100% of all my mixed colors. The ones that I only use maybe, a quarter of, I definitely keep these and keep using them over time. So I mix it all in this container, pour that into the base, and then put that on my hair. But the ones that I haven't mixed, I definitely save and continue using. And then the color silk that comes inside the Revlon, I save these up. I don't necessarily use these when I color my hair, and I take these when we travel. Maui, I must have used 8-9 of them. I washed my hair almost every day there with snorkeling and boogie boarding. I had so much sand in it, and this is an amazing conditioner, and it's a very convenient way to take it traveling with you. Trader Joe's Stevia, I love this. I think price-wise, it's 630 servings. It has this tiny little scoop in it. It is phenomenal. Now, it's not convenient for me for when I travel, but for at home, I always have it like this. It's just very, very convenient, and price-wise, it works great. When I travel, I do buy the Costco Stevia packets and take those with me in a baggie, but love this and have already repurchased. This is the last of my hormonal cream that I had compounded for me. I think it's like $150 a month or something. And I liked it. I didn't like paying $150 a month. I may have to. I'm going back to my regular progesterone cream, and I'm not sure if it's working or not. It's either my thyroid or my progesterone. It's constant. With going vegan, I'm getting healthier, which is good. But man, it's a pain having something out of whack all the time, where I'm not sleeping and too much energy and all this stuff. So I would go to my doctor, get my hormones and thyroid checked, but we'll see if I end up back on this or if it's the thyroid or what. Speaking of thyroid, get yours checked. I went through that. And then my monolaurin, somebody said that these are not vegan, and I don't normally purchase the ecological formulas. I purchased, I think it's Health from the Sun. I'll make sure I put all the links below. I used up this Andalou Naturals Heavenly Night Cream. I ordered a sample kit, and I loved trying all the different things. This is not something I would probably repurchase, but I did enjoy it for travel. These Vivo Moisturizing Day Creams, I don't even know where I got these. They were just okay, nothing spectacular, would not repurchase. And this Queen Helene scrub, I think I have one or two more. I purchased them in a 3-pack off Amazon, shouldn't have done that. Don't really like the scrubbies. I'm looking for something that's a little more gentle but still exfoliating. Not sure what I'll use after this. For my rinse, I love the Trader Joe's cleanser, but this scrub I would not repurchase. I will use it up though, the one that I have. Alpha Hydroxy, I purchase this sometimes like this and sometimes in the pump. Some people have said that Walgreens don't carry it anymore. Mine still does, but I've also heard that maybe Walmart does, and I think there might be links online. If I can find them, I'll put them below. St. Ives, love, 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 love this stuff. Even if I have a cream I don't like, I'll mix half and half with this because I love this so much and it just makes everything wonderful. I have a beauty blender sponge. It is starting to disintegrate, so I'm going to get rid of it, but also I much prefer the Beauty Junkies 3-pack of the black sponges with the diagonal that kind of looks like the Real Technique, even though they're black. And I think I get them 3 for $12. I'll put a link below. Those are so much better. I will not repurchase a beauty blender sponge. I have 2 nail polishes. This one came in a gift pack a couple of Christmases ago. I actually have it on my toes right now, but it's done. It's getting kind of thick, so I'm going to let it go. And same with this Essence Color & Go. I really, really loved it. I used it up very quickly. Probably within a year, which is fast for me. I'm trying to focus on using up my nail polishes more, but I also like to rotate. This is a really pretty color, and when I am down on my nail polishes, it's probably one that I would go back and repurchase. This Elizabeth & James Nirvana Rose, it's heavy. I tried putting it on lighter. Mark hated it, so I am letting it go even though it's not all done. This L'Oreal 300, it's very sticky, it's goopy, I'm just going to let it go, it's not worth it for me. And then this was part of my use-up, this Kate 104, so I'm really happy to be done with that. It was okay, it's nothing amazing, it doesn't last overly long, I like the color, but for me, Wet n Wild, those last much longer for me. My lashes that I get off of eBay are the K19. Absolutely love these. I cut them in half and put them on my outer lash. And of course, I'm not wearing them today, but normally I do. And I really feel like it helps with my hooded eyes to open them up and lift them up. Absolutely love those. Another lipstick from my use up is the Wet n Wild 906D. I really, really love this color. Enjoyed using it. And yet, I'm glad it's gone because I have so many other lipsticks. We're talking on the Facebook page of one girl who went through and swatched all of her reds and compared them and got rid of some, and then all of her oranges. I need to do that because just pulling a couple out of the fridge and getting rid of the ones that I don't like this L'Oreal lip gloss, as I go, and then using the rest of them, and then going back and pulling some more, it's just too slow. I need to go through and really swatch and eliminate some of them, so I might have to make some time to do that. Not sure when now that I'm back at work, but we'll see. This NYX blush in Rose Petal, it's done. I love it. It was really nice. I always put my cream colored blush on and then a powder blush over top, and the powder blush sets it as well as makes it last longer. And I really did enjoy that Rose Petal. I have so many cream blushes, though, I'm not going to be repurchasing. This LA Girl Pro Conceal in Natural, I really liked it and I love the color. It is a bit thick. It's accentuating my under eye wrinkles, and I don't need any help in showing those off. So I don't think I would repurchase. For me, it's still the Maybelline. I love that. The Age Rewind. My Milani Conceal and Perfect. This is number 2. I can do 1, 2, and 3, believe it or not, in that foundation, depending on the time of year. What I have found, for a while, I hated this. And it's because I wasn't using my Beauty Blender sponge. It needs for me to be put onto the sponge. When I use it with my fingers, that leaves a thicker application, and it just showed every pore. It looked thick and cakey, and it just was not flattering. When I use a sponge, love this. Really great coverage, lasts all day, and covers everything. This ColourPop eyeshadow in Amaze, I really enjoyed it as a topper, so when you have a color on your eye, I put this over top. I would never use it alone. It was really nice, but I would not repurchase. I have too many, and if I was to repurchase, a similar one that I like much better is the L'Oreal Amber Rush Infallible Shadow. That you can use on its own, and it has the same effect. In fact, I like the L'Oreal Infallible much better than this. This Physician's Formula Shimmer Strip, it's too shimmery. And obviously shimmer things you want to put on the eye. It's not light enough to have as an accent color. It's not dark enough to have as like a one shadow look. It's just not a color that works for me. Plus it's cool tone, and I'm not a big cool tone fan. I got given some palettes, and I have decided every palette that I take in, I'm going to get rid of something because I'm just not using the eyeshadows the way that I need to in order to put a dent in my stash. So I don't want to take in extra palettes. I actually got 2 and I'm getting rid of 3. I'm getting rid of this Elle eye enhancing shadow. It's just all matte, and I don't use all matte. I like a mixture of shimmer and matte. Same with this LA Colors. I just like a mixture, although these oranges are my shade. I have other ones that I like much better. And then this Balm Nude Tude, it just, I don't reach for it. It's not the colors that I like. It does have some shimmers, but it's just nothing spectacular for me. And I don't know if it's the packaging or what, but I just don't reach for it, so I will not be repurchasing any Balm packaging. Because for myself, I don't know why, I just don't like that. So those are my empties for the month. Thanks for hanging out with me. I hope this was helpful, and I hope you're having a fabulous day. We'll talk to you next time. Have a look. Thank you. Are you done? Let me know when you're done.